My dear students, today's topic is transpiration in plants. What is transpiration? Transpiration is the evaporation of excess amount of water from the aerial parts of the plant. Now and then transpiration is taking place. It is an invisible process taking place mainly through the leaves of the plant. When the stomata are kept open, automatically evaporation of water takes place. Stomata are open in the daytime and closed at night. Opening and closing of the stomata is due to the changes in the turgidity of the guard cells. When water enters into the guard cells, they become turgid and the stomata will open. When the guard cells lose water, it becomes flaccid and the stomata will be closed. So, due to the action of the guard cells, what are guard cells? Guard cells are bean shaped structure present in each stoma. Each stoma consists of two bean shaped structure that is called guard cells. Only guard cells will take a role in order to maintain the opening and closing of the stomata. When water evaporates from the mesophyll tissue of the leaf through the open stomata, this lowers water concentration in the mesophyll cells. As a result, more water is drawn into the mesophyll cells from the xylem present in the veins through the process called osmosis. So, by means of osmosis, water enter into the mesophyll cells through the xylem. As water is lost from the mesophyll tissue of the leaves, a pressure is created at the top of the mesophyll cells to pull more water from the xylem to the mesophyll cells. This process is called transpiration pull. Mainly transpiration pull is responsible for absorption of water from the root, from the soil by the root gas. Transpiration pull extends up to the roots, consuming the roots to absorb water from the soil to ensure continuous flow of water from the roots to the leaves. So that is about transpiration pull. What is transpiration pull? When the evaporation is taking place, loss of water takes place in the mesophyll cells. When continuous evaporation of water takes place through the stomata of the leaves, there is a loss of water in the mesophyll tissue. That's why a pressure is created in the mesophyll tissue, which will draw water molecules from stem, and from the stem water moves towards the mesophyll cells of the leaf, and that pressure, that is the suction pressure created in the mesophyll tissue of the leaf, that is called transpiration pull. There are factors affecting transpiration. These are all the factors. Factors are classified into two types: external factors and internal factors. External factors outside the plant, what are the factors affecting the transpiration, collectively called external factors? Number one, temperature. Number two, light. Number three, humidity. And number four, wind speed. If you take temperature or light or humidity or wind speed, that will increase or reduce the transpiration according to the factor. If you take temperature, more temperature will evaporate more water molecules from the surface of the leaf, like that light also. If there is a humidity in the air, that will reduce the transpiration. Like that wind speed also determines the evaporation of water molecules from the surface of the leaf. Come to the internal factors. A number of factors within the plant cell consider as the internal factors. Number and distribution of the stomata, percentage of the open stomata, water status of the plant, canopy structure. See, as far as number and distribution of the stomata are concerned, more number of stomata, transpiration will be more. Less number of stomata, transpiration will be less. Like that, percentage of open stomata. When more stomata are kept open, that will evaporate more water through the stomata. Water status of the plant. Inside the plant, when enough water is there, more water will be evaporated. When less water is present, the rate of transpiration will be less. Canopy structure, the top layer of the plant. The shoot system consists of aerial pores and the terminal part of the plant, that is considered as the canopy structure. If you take plants, this is canopy. The top of the plant, which contain more leaves, dense amount of leaves occupied at the terminal portion of the plant, that is the canopy. When canopy structure is large, more, and that will evaporate more water, more transpiration takes place. Right, you see the diagram figure 14.7. The gauze cells in turgid and flaccid condition is given in detail. You can refer it. This is the swollen gauze cell. When more water enter into the gauze cells, the gauze cell will swell, and that will make the turgidity of the gauze cell. And when water, during endosmosis, more water enter into the cell, so that will make the turgidity of the gauze cell. When water come out of the gauze cell, in some external factors, due to some external factors, the gauze cell will make flaccidity condition, that is the shrinking of the gauze cells takes place. In each stoma, there are two bean-shaped gauze cells are there. In each gauze cell, you can see a nucleus, chloroplast. At the center, there is a big vacuole. The two gauze cells, when they are in flaccid condition, that will open the stomata. When the gauze cells will make a turgidity condition, that will make the stomata to open. When no water is present in the gauze cells, so that will make the flaccid condition of the gauze cell, so that the stomata will be closed. So that is about the structure of the stomata. So consider, when the gauze cells are in full turgid condition, then only the stomata will open. When the gauze cells are in flaccid condition, the stomata will be closed. Come to the significance of transpiration. The transpiration creates transpiration pool for the transport of water. Due to continuous transpiration, there is a pool is created in the mesophyll tissue of the leaf. That is called transpiration pool. That will uplift the water from stem and roots of the plant. Second, it supplies water for photosynthesis. In the leaves, in the aerial parts of the plant, photosynthesis takes place. In the green parts of the plant, photosynthesis takes place. For photosynthesis, water is essential. Water is one of the raw material for the preparation of carbohydrate during photosynthesis. So the plant will supply water for photosynthesis. Due to transpiration, transpiration pool is created, which will absorb more water and supply the more water to the leaves of the plant for photosynthesis. Transport minerals from the soil to all parts of the plant. Along with the water absorption, the root air also absorbs some of the minerals from the soil. That is also taking place, that is also connected with the transpiration pool. During transpiration, transpiration pool is created in the mesophyll tissue of the leaf that will collect water, that will absorb water, that will suck water from the stem and from the root. The root has will absorb water from the soil continuously. So along with that, minerals also absorb and transported. Cools the surface of the leaves of evaporation of water. Due to the evaporation of water, cooling effect is taking place on the surface of the plant and the surface of the leaves, that is. Then keeps the cells turgid, hence maintains their shape. Due to continuous water supply, the cell's turgidity will be maintained, so that in the full turgidity of the cell, continuous physiological process is taking place, and also the cell shape will be maintained. Right, if it pass on to root pressure, as we have seen, there is a pressure created in the xylem of the root due to the continuous supply of water to the xylem from the root gas. Root gas absorb water and minerals from the soil, and the absorbed water through the stem reaches the leaf, and so that in that process, when the water reaches the xylem of the root, in the xylem of the root, a pressure is created that will enforce the water to the aerial parts of the plant. That pressure created in the xylem of the root, that is called root pressure. So always root pressure will be taking place in the xylem of the root. When the xylem gets more water, absorbed water by the root gas from the soil. So that is the transpiration pool, factors affecting transpiration, the structure of stomata, and the significance of transpiration. Finally, root pressure we have seen.